Here's a couple of things about MTHFR. It stands for one of those geeky, long scientific words. And I've been doing very bad with pronouncing words today. I'm sure I'll butcher this one. Methylene tetrahydrofolate reductase. Now, I'm not going to say that three times fast, but MTHFR is related to a thing called methylation. Now, you may have heard of that. There's a whole set of topics and debate about it on YouTube. And in fact, there was a Doc Z-Dog, MD. He's a hospitalist, intensivist, that does a lot of videos on YouTube. And he actually did one on it. And he basically gave the standard statement that most docs give on it. Yes, it does exist. Yes, it is real. But no, it's not significant. Well, if you're an intensivist, it's not significant to you. But if you're a human being and you're worried about aging and developing eye disease, especially associated with insulin resistance, any of these oxidative processes, the most prevalent and the most oxidative of which is insulin resistance, prediabetes, and diabetes. These are very oxidative processes. That's where the whole antioxidant vitamin thing came along. Now, you've heard of antioxidants, vitamins A, C, and E, and they're very, very prevalent. But one thing that you may not have heard of is simple vitamin B. And why would I be talking about vitamin B in terms of antioxidants? It's not really one of the classic antioxidant supplements, is it? No, it's not. If you go to things like, you just go to Amazon and look up Thorne, T-H-O-R-N-E, Methyl Guard Plus, any of those items. Thorne Methyl Guard. I have Dr. Brown actually got me started on another one, which is a little bit more powerful. It's called a supplemental food. It's Restore Me. And it's the same thing as a Thorne Methyl Guard, except it has a higher level of methyl folate. Now, why are we talking about methylated B vitamins? So let's get back to the MTHFR mutation. And by the way, I have it. I am a poor methylator. There are three major methylation metabolism problems, two of which are by far the major ones, and I have both of them. It's very common. Over half of us have some type of methylation challenge. Why do I keep saying methylation, and why do I keep talking about B vitamins, and what has all that got to do with antioxidants? So you go back to high school chemistry and you hear about oxidation versus reduction. Oxidation is addition of an oxygen molecule. That's how it got its name. So, you know, when you burn something, it's got to have oxygen in order to burn or oxidize quickly. Then you get into the chemistry lab or the chemistry textbooks, and you remember that reduction is antioxidation. It's adding that electron back. Because another thing that's happening with oxidation is not just adding an oxygen molecule, you're also taking an electron away. So you add that electron back and you get reduction. Well, the human body does, we use oxidation. That's what we talked about multiple times. That's what this whole NAD plus thing was about. NAD is one of the substrates for this happening, niacin, right? So B vitamins carry methyl groups and they transfer methyl groups back and forth. That's actually what's going on in the oxidation reduction processes in the human body. So back to Z-Dog MD. No, if the patient's already in the ICU where he works, no, it doesn't matter too much. But if you're trying to avoid eye disease, for example, associated with aging, methylation is a clear determinant of how quickly you get eye disease and the other breakdown products of oxidation. So if you are a poor methylator like me, you should take these B vitamin complexes that have already been methylated. So what happens is your body doesn't pull these methyl groups very well, but if you're supplementing, you're basically replacing those methyl groups with a supplement in a place like with folate and niacin and other B vitamins where you can replace those methyl groups. In other words, your own inherent antioxidation. Most people would not have known that A, MTHFR deals with methylators, and B, that it's so, I wanted to say another geeky word, apropos. It's so much related to the topic of today. This whole NAD thing is transfer of methyl groups back and forth in our energy management processes, metabolism. Why wait for a disease and hope for a cure? I used to be an ER doc. My name is Ford Brewer. I quit ER after a few years because it was just so frustrating. Most of the things bringing people into the ER are things that should have been prevented, including heart attack, stroke, number one cause of death, number one cause of permanent disability. People think that you're just going to have those and that they're not predictable. Both of those are wrong. They are predictable, and you don't have to have them. Usually it's lifestyle. Lifestyle is more important than supplements and even prescription drugs and even stents and surgery. But the current times are tough. Major financial impact with the lockdowns that most states have been going through. We've been working on a way to make this much more affordable with a subscription process, and that's exactly what we're announcing today. We've got two levels. One is the Silver membership, where you get access to our courses, a private webinar each month, and access to our supplement store and supplement recommendations and prescription. Or I would suggest even more so, the Gold membership. You can get a script for a freestyle Libre and find out what your blood sugar metabolism's doing on a daily basis. And you can get a lab order for inflammation, OGTT, and insulin survey. You can also get a 30-minute one-on-one with me. So I'm looking forward to seeing you. Cost is no longer an excuse. So if you're interested, go to go.prevmedheartrest.com/prevmed-subscription or call us at 859-721-1414, 859-721-1414, or email us at myhealth@prevmedheartrest.com. Looking forward to seeing you. Thank you.